Well, hello. Okay. I feel like God wants me to make this video. Now, number one, I know y'all be watching my other videos and y'all are like, come on now, God telling this girl to make a video. But you know, I see a lot of things in the spiritual realm that other people may not see. I am extremely smart. Y'all may not realize that, but I am. And there's just things that God shows me in the spiritual realm, or just little things of knowledge that I know. And I mean, even if you're not a believer, if you don't, this right here, what I'm about to teach you is very interesting. I'm about to break down for you and explain to you what the demons really are, because they are not who we are led to believe that they are. We are led to believe that the demons are the fallen angels of Satan. That is not who the demons are. The fallen angels of Satan are still in the heavenly realm. In Revelations, it says that would be cast down to the heaven. That's when the Antichrist comes. That's the war of the heavens. That has not happened yet. They are still in the heavenly realm. They are not the demons. They are not the evil spirits. And let me first say that before the flood of Noah, you never heard, not once in the Bible, of a person being led by evil spirit, of someone being possessed by evil spirit. You never did, because the evil spirits were not there yet to possess them. Okay, let's get it. All right, so we're in Genesis chapter 6:1. Now it came to pass, when men began to multiply on the face of the earth, and daughters were born to them, that the sons of God saw the daughters of men. Okay, let me tell you who this is. The sons of God, those are for the fallen angels. Not necessarily the fallen angels that came, that were following Satan. But if you read the book of Enoch, which a lot of people think that the book of Enoch is a deception, it's not really of God, which I don't believe that. I have read the book of Enoch, and it will explain to you, they're called the Watchers, who these angels actually were. And they got together and made a pact and decided to go marry the women, because angels were never meant to marry. They were never meant to eat or drink. They were just meant to watch after humans. Okay? So, and then the daughters of men, those are us humans, the daughters. Okay? Okay, the sons of God saw the daughters of men. So, we'll just put it like this. The fallen angels saw the humans. the human women, that they were beautiful, and they took wives for themselves and all whom they chose. So meaning they went and found wives for themselves, which was deliberately rebellion of God, because the angels are not meant to marry. Okay? And the Lord said, my spirit shall not strive with man forever, for he is indeed flesh, yet his days shall be numbered 120 years. I mean, this 120 years is how long that they have to repent. Because God, when God tells Noah to build the ark, he's going to be building this ark for 123 years. And let me tell you that at this point in time, rain had never fell from the sky. Rain came up out of the ground. They had never been rain from the sky. So the whole time Noah's building this ark, they're all like, you're an idiot, you're stupid, they're mocking him, you retard, there's not going to be rain fall from the sky, what are you talking about, rain come from the ground, and everything was replenished, and they didn't have to work hard, you know what I'm saying? Okay, so, all right, there were giants in the earth of those days. Now, if the word giant, when we think of giant, we think of huge people, but if you actually take it back to the Hebrew text of giant is Nephilim. Okay, Nephilim. They were Nephilim on the earth in those days, and also afterward. When the sons of God came into the daughters of men, which means they had sex, came in them and got them pregnant, came into the daughters of men, they bore children to them, and those were the mighty men who were of old, men of renown. Okay, those were the old men of renown. So, then the Lord saw that the wickedness of man was great upon the earth, and that every intent and every thought of his heart was only evil continually, and that he was sorry that he had made man upon the earth, and he grieved after his heart. Then he said, I was to destroy whom I have created. On the face of the earth, both man, beast, creeping, crawling things, birds, for I am sorry that I have made them. But Noah had found grace in his eyes, so he told Noah to build this ark, you know what I'm saying? So he had found grace in his eyes. Here's another deception that we are led to believe. We believe that God told Noah to take two of all these animals, you know what I'm saying? And two of every animal and just bring them in the ark. But that is also not so. God told Noah that of the birds of the air, okay, he said, of all living flesh and everything in the ark, to keep them alive, thou shalt be male and female. Of the birds of their kind, of animals after their kind, and of every creeping thing after their kind, you will keep them alive. And shall take them of food for yourself to be eaten and gathered. At that point in time, men did not eat animals. Animals and men got along together. There was no fear in them, and there was no meat ever eaten. You only ate vegetables and things. And you shall take food for yourself and gather it. Okay, and then where does it say? Okay, and for the animals, take each the male and female. Okay, now you shall take seven of each clean animal, male and female. Take two of each unclean animal, male and female. Also of the birds of the air, male and female, take seven of them. Not two, but seven. And okay, so, and they brought themselves onto the ark. Noah didn't have to go get them. They just walked themselves onto the ark. And that's how it happened, because men were straight with animals in days, and God, I guess, told them men, you know, whatever. So back to the point. I just want to see some things that we get taught and we get told that's not actually true. So you got to take this and read it for yourself and see what you see. You know what I'm saying? So, okay. So then, so the flood came for 40 days and 40 nights, and the water rose so high that even the birds drowned. Okay. See, I need you to understand that the flood was not meant to punish man, but it was meant to punish the fallen angels for their hybrid species that they have created with humans, because they were violence upon the earth. You know, God didn't mean for them to mix. It was really to punish the fallen angels, because he was killing off their children, because actually the world had become more Nephilim than what it was human, okay? And the Nephilims were completely evil. So after the flood, well, first I'm going to tell you this much. It's a lot of things, okay, because it says there's a great man of renown. I just want to put some things out there like this, because I be knowing some stuff. But a lot of these Greek things, okay, for instance, like Zeus ended his whole world in a flood and told his son to build an ark to survive, but his son did not survive, okay? Athenius Enel heard noises, and the people were so loud that the gods could not sleep. So he flooded the world because of the noise. But the gods became cowards and become scared. These are the pagan gods. Why would you be scared of the flood you created? So they tried to climb onto the ark that they told to be built. Okay, so everything kind of falls down from this. But you see, everything was destroyed upon the earth, and then everyone was descendants of Noah. So there were stories to be told. Like, can you imagine telling the stories of all the Nephilim, this, this, and that? So how it would come down, and then you would hear it, and it would turn into this and turn into that. That's why Hercules was the son of Zeus and I can't say it, Astemia or whatever. That Hercules was the son of a god and a human, which made him human strength, but everyone ever saw him because he was also destroyed in the flood that Zeus created. Okay, Helen and Troy, the daughter of Zeus and Lena, because he had a lot of kids with a lot of humans, you know what I'm saying? And then Ramesses, the son of Zeus and Euryphea, right? They were all sons of gods and humans. But see, how, for all we know, that Zeus may have been one of the Nephilim, so that's how these stories came down, you know, because once they were told. I just thought that was pretty interesting and some knowledge to have. But this is what I'm trying to tell y'all right here and right now. Okay, what we have been taught was demons and these demonic spirits. We've been taught that was the devil and his fallen angels. Absolutely not. The devil and his fallen angels are still in the heavenly realm. They've not been cast down yet into the war. The Nephilim spirits, half human, half angels, they have nowhere to go after they die. They are cursed to be on the earth because they're half human and half human and half angel. Where did they go to? There's nowhere for them to go. So they're cursed on the earth, and their fathers are bound down in pits. So these spirits that attached to us, and these things that we see as demons, these are the Nephilim spirits. They are able to possess us because they are half human. They are able to come into our minds and know how we work because they are half humans. They know how to deceive us because they are half fallen angel of evil. Okay, so we have been taught to believe that these demons are these fallen angels that have came descended down from heaven, the fallen angels. No, it is the hybrid species, their children. Those are who possess us. Some of us completely possess, some of us are attached to these demons. But just know that these are not the fallen angels. These are spirits that are traveling around this earth, that are doing anything to get inside of our bodies. So they want to be in a body form because they are just nothing but air floating around. Do you understand what I'm saying? They want to come into our bodies, and when they do, they want to destroy us of all evil. It is the Nephilim, the children of the fallen angels and the human beings. People, you have to take and learn for yourself, you know what I'm saying? Because we are so, like, deceived. And it says in the beginning, in the end will be like, in the times of the end will be like the times of the beginning. What I also believe is, in the beginning when Eve was deceived into eating the apple, it says that the great dragon, the most cunning of all creatures, okay? So we don't know what a dragon looked like, but it sure enough wasn't a snake with legs. He seduced Eve into eating the apple. We know what seduced means, right? Yes, we do. And so I believe that Eve had sex with Satan. I believe she did. That was the first Nephilim spirit. That was the first son of Satan, which was Cain, born from, I think that Cain was born from Satan and Eve. And then she bore Abel from her and Adam, okay? And then that's why Cain slew Abel. And he was the first son of Satan. That is why when the Luciferians and the people who worship the devil, they say that they can't come from the bloodline of Cain, which actually they do. That's the first Nephilim bloodline. Satan did start that off. Okay, so and in the end, the beginning will be as the end. So when the Antichrist comes, he will be the son of Satan. He will be just as in the beginning, because in the beginning will be the same as the end. That's what it says. He will be another son of Satan born upon the earth, and the Antichrist will be again the son of Satan, a Nephilim. Now, it does say in Matthew that it will be like the times of in Noah, where they were eating and drinking and marrying and taking in marriage of, meaning the angels do not eat or drink and they do not marry. I'm not sure if they will actually be born upon the earth again, or it will be because we are possessed by them. But these are the demonic evil spirits that we wrestle against. It is not the fallen angels. It is the Nephilim. I just wanted to fill you with them facts. Take what you will from that. But I just thought that was some facts that I should let y'all know about, because I know. Thank you. God bless.